It's the NFL on EA Sports, and there you get a look at Paul Brown Stadium on the banks of the Ohio River in Cincinnati. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Cleveland Browns and the Cincinnati Bengals.
Now this will make it into the end zone. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
The Browns take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
They will run for the first time with David Montgomery. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
And 11 at the 22-yard line.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. From the gun, Jackson. Flushed, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Jordan Phillips, credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of six. Here's Jackson on third and long. And quickly into the hands of Robinson. And he will be marked down short of the first as they get to him at the 29. It'll be a pickup of 13, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. So on fourth down, here's Sam Cook to punt it away. And he was called on three times in the win last week as his first one here's away. That'll be a 44-yard boot, just a yard on the return as he's covered up quickly. And the Bengals will take over here first and 10. Looking to throw from. He rifles complete, caught by Moore. That catch good for only a couple.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. Now the first carry here for Phillip Lindsay. They follow up the gain of 2 with a gain of 1 that time.
That's a really good job right there. Just kept stringing that play out, pushing further and further towards the sideline. Really good fundamentals by that defense.
He was trying to put his foot in the ground and turn upfield. He just couldn't.
No, they really had a picket fence in front of him. No room to find to get upfield.
From the gun, it's Fromm.
And he's got his target. That's Moore.
And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
6-yard line.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
It's a first down following a gain of 3. Well, they gave themselves options there on the third down play and were able to convert on that RPO.
Shows a lot of trust with the guy taking the snap, doesn't it? Because you're counting on him to make the right reads and give the ball where it's supposed to go. And he did on that play.
On first down, Fromm. He'll get this one complete. That's A.J. Brown. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. A gain of three last play. This time they double it and pick up six. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion. So here's second and four. It inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
And that's something you have to get ready for defensively, because in today's NFL, teams will use their wide receivers on jet sweeps, end arounds. They'll move them back in the backfield to make them running backs. Partner, this was much more of a tap pass, but effective nonetheless.
And I think both guys love it. If you're a quarterback, it's an easy completion. If you're a wide receiver, you get the easy reception and also a chance to try to make a play with your feet. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. Nothing at all on that one. It'll be second down. They couldn't get anything going there out of the right side of the flat of the swing pass.
And didn't we have a discussion with their staff about wanting to get the backs more involved in the passing game? Huge emphasis for this game, but obviously the defense had other plans and really made a nice play.
On second down, here's Fromm. He'll drop this one down to Freeman. 5 yards, now it's third and five.
I'm not sure that this play was designed for him specifically, but they got through the progressions and got the ball to him. So second catch on the drive. He may not be a primary guy, but they definitely want him involved, don't they?
Absolutely. This early, the opening drive, as you said, two catches. So if they can get him going in the passing game, that should open up his running game too. Out of the shotgun, here's Fromm. Throw left side, complete. It's Freeman, and he is going to have a Bengals first down. He needed five. He got it barely, as it will officially go down as a gain of 5 yards.
First and 10 at the 21-yard line.
No score after one on EA Sports.
No score.
First and 10 from. And throw right side complete to Parker. This will be a 5-yard pickup as they move it from the 20 to the 15.
It's a gain of five.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible. Hope he's got man-to-man coverage and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And that one, his first incompletion in his last six passes. And it's third down.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
Throwing is from. The Browns D locked in on third down. Brings up fourth. The linebacker Miles Jack able to knock that one away.
And that's a nice job there, because you've got to play the ball, not the man, when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. And he's able to knock that one away.
Well, that will go down as a 15-play drive, and it results in 3 points. So some disappointment.
It's funny, we had our conference before the game with the offensive coordinator. And what did he tell us? I just want every drive to end in a kick, right? An extra point, a punt, or a field goal. Well, in this case, I think it is a little bit of a disappointment, because it did end in a kick, but that type of a drive should end in the end zone.
The Browns drive about to get started, and they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense.
And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds.
Can almost see inside his face mask there, the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture. 15 more yards there, and quickly another first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went three and out.
First down, they run again. Here's Montgomery. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. And now timeout is whistled as it appears there's a Brown shaken up on the play. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. Play action. It's Jackson on the move to his left. Now he'll pull it down, and he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line.
Well, we've seen Jackson already have success in the first half running the football, and he gets good yardage on the ground again there. I mean, how? I know it's a $64,000 question, CD, but how do they contain him better?
You have to win against the blockers ahead of you. If those guys even occupy a defender for even a half a second, then Lamar Jackson is gone. You got to take those blockers and move them so that you have clear vision of Lamar Jackson. And
under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31.
Brian Burns, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
After the sack, it's 2nd and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
He was trying to find his tight end, Josh Oliver,
and it's 3rd down. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
Throwing on 3rd and long, Jackson. And that'll bring up 4th down as his Cincy defense stands up on 3rd.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts. This time on 3rd down.
And the 11-year veteran bangs it through. And that will tie us at 3-3.
Maybe a little fortunate there. That was leaking a little. Maybe leaking a lot, but he got it.
Yeah, he actually was able to make it work. How about the body language, though, right? As he watched that ball leak to the right, trying to bring it back in. And had just enough to get it done.
At the 25-yard line, the Bengals take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you've met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants to drive in with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. 15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. 1st down.
All right, I got to ask you, with these RPOs, essentially the quarterback has 3 options, right? So what's different from that versus the triple option that we see the service academies run at the college level?
As a general rule, the triple option at the college level, most things are called outside of the quarterback faking it to the runner and then keeping it himself and maybe having a trail back. What I mean is, in the NFL, that option to throw the football all comes about organically. It's a natural deal based on reads. In college, if you're going to throw the football off a triple option, you've actually called that play.
He was trying to get it to A.J. Brown that time, but it'll be 2nd down.
A.J. Boye on the coverage.
They'll get this out in a hurry to Parker. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 11 yards there, 1st down.
Was that a design pass, or what was that?
It was built into the play call. He had the opportunity to either hand it inside, keep it himself to run it, or do what he just did. Throw that pass inside, hitting a receiver on the run.
Oh,
So a first and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 48-yard line. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. Boy, an effective play there, getting their wideouts involved in the run game.
And what they're always hoping on that type of a play, that they can get to the end of the line and have a chance to turn it upfield as he did there. That means they controlled the blocking and took care of the defensive end or the outside linebacker to give him that lane.
And I guess I need to clarify, I said getting their wideouts involved in the run game, but of course that was actually a pass as he popped it forward. They'll throw on first down with Fromm. He'll find Parker again, complete. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. Devontae Parker with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Bengals have taken the lead. And a nice job by him to catch the slant and then navigate and break free.
And receivers love slant routes because it gets the ball in their hands so quickly and oftentimes on the move. When they're on the move like that, then they get to use their best asset, which is usually their speed.
And their speed sometimes, like this instance, can take them into the end zone. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. And now timeout is whistled as it appears there's a Brown shaken up on the play. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. The Browns drive about to get started. Just a lone field goal for them so far, trailing 10-3 as they come up first and 10. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line.
They were in the top 5 in sacks in the league coming into this one. That's their 3rd one in this game. Obviously, pass rush has been a strength of this team all year long.
And apparently, they're not satisfied with top 5. They want to climb that ladder.
Yeah, I think it goes back to their offseason. They decided to make it a priority, and it's working out.
Another try after the first down sack. Jackson, he'll fire it deep. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way in, touchdown, Cleveland. Jalen Reagor, 92 yards. And the Browns are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And I think it's safe to say we won't call many touchdown passes longer than that this year, partner.
No, I would agree with that totally. And right now you're looking at an offensive coordinator. Conservative would not go next to his name. Risk taker, definitely, because he valued the opportunity to create a big play against what could have been disaster if they end up getting sacked or fumbling the ball in the shadow of their own goal line.
The Bengals take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Bengals drive about to get going. There have been points on the board. We just saw back-to-back touchdown drives. I love it. I'm high-fiving our statistician, Christian McLeod, and you're angry. You're a defensive guy.
If you met one of my defensive coordinators, God rest his soul, I'm surprised he isn't in this booth right now wanting to really take you on. This is not football the way he sees it. He wants a good old-fashioned kicking game, defense, field position, and we're getting an up-and-down-the-field game here.
I'll take him. Where's his tombstone?
Boot Hill, baby.
Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
It's second and inches at the 47-yard line.
Fromm off of play action. It's complete to Brown, right side. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
First and 10 at the 34-yard line.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10.
Mike is 59. Mike the 59. Let's put him on the buses. Let's put that team on the bus.
Fromm. He's going deep for Brown. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. This secondary has been roasted in this first half, and they get a measure of revenge there. Nice play on the deep ball.
Yeah, they're going to need a few more plays like that in order to get their confidence fully back, but that's one step in the proper direction.
Now an option play on second down. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
And incomplete, he dropped it. Maybe a rookie mistake there. Second down.
It's now second and 10.
To throw again, Jackson. That ball caught by the former Toledo Rocket, Deontay Johnson. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Gain on the play. First down, Cleveland.
Jackson from the shotgun. He gets it left side to Johnson. Now he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. To throw again on second down, Jackson. And this is caught at the 8. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. To throw again is Jackson, dancing to his left. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. The Browns will quickly use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the all-pro safety, Minkah Fitzpatrick. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
Intercepted. The Bengals take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. And the ball backed way up, so thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half. Up at the 29 now, they'll head to the line, second and a yard. Here's Fromm to throw. He's going deep for Brown. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And he will be brought down as time has now run out on this first half of action. So we have reached halftime here at a good one. 10-10 is our score. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. From the 10. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
First and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
The The Bengals drive about to get going. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up.
First and 10 at the 43-yard line.
On first and 10, it's Lindsey. And he'll take this one across the 45 up to about the 46-yard line. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
Brings up second and 7.
They'll look to throw, and he's taken down. This will be a Brown sack. Melvin Ingram able to record his 5th sack of the season. Chalk that up as their first sack in this game, and they tallied 4 a week ago.
And probably not as much exultation in that sack as what took us so long. Because when you get 4 the previous week, you're counting on continuing that momentum. They didn't get that done in the first half of the game. Let's see now if they start to bring even more exotic pressure towards the quarterback.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. He gets it to Brown, complete. It's a first down, his 4th catch of the game after having 3 in the first half.
I know that rookie quarterbacks have to earn veteran receivers' trust. Maybe we saw that on that play with that type of effort, huh?
Yeah, helping out the rook with a heck of a catch. The throw there finding its way to Boyle. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
It's a pickup. Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Now Fromm to pass on second down. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 16 yards, a first down. And that's now 4 completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
And so close, he gets it to the 1. Out of bounds right there. He's been a one-man wrecking crew these last couple of plays. This time 18 more, and a first down.
Goal at the 1-yard line.
They'll try to run with Lindsey. And this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the 3. A loss of 2 there. Second down.
A loss of 2. Brings up
one more time with Lindsey. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's 3rd and goal.
A gain of 3 yards. It's now 3rd and goal.
They'll try to run with Lindsey, and he's going to run into a brick wall right in the middle of the field, and I don't think he got there. No gain on the play, and what to do now on 4th and goal.
Brings up 4th and goal.
The offense is staying out there. Here we go on 4th and goal from the 1. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the 3rd quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this 3rd quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
And he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line. He was brought down by Eric Wilson. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. From the gun, it's Jackson. And quickly into the hands of Robinson. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. 15 yards on the play, first down. From the gun, Jackson. The attempt on the dive, and he has it. What a catch. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
A gain of 11 on the play.
They go play action with Jackson. Escaping the pressure right. Here's Johnson with a reception. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble.
First down, Cleveland.
First down, here's the run to Montgomery. And he's going to get this one down to the 30.
The ball carrier.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Brings up second and
so the scoring dried up here in the third. Nothing that quarter for either side. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. On second and nine. Jackson, that one complete to Hill. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. Called that a very strong gain of 24. Operating from the gun, Jackson. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked by Nick Kwiatkowski. And a short return will be stopped inside the 10 at the 8-yard line. Tie game, fourth quarter. You're already in the red zone, well in field goal range. You can't throw a pick there.
And you know I want to give all the credit to the defenders, right? I mean, they made a play on the ball. But bottom line, you set up the situation perfectly. You've already got the field goal in the bag. You've got to make sure you take care of the football in that situation.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. That's into the hands of the tight end, Boyle. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Second and 1 at the 17-yard line.
That's out to the left, flat and complete. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. Play action, it's from. Looking left side, that's caught by Moore. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35.
To David Moore. Out of bounds at the 35-yard line. A 7-yard pickup.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3. From the gun, it's Fromm. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line.
Brandon, you know this is going to be discussed because this is the fear of all the backs when they run this type of a route. They've got to find the football, and sometimes they don't see the defender. And in this case, he took a pretty good shot for his efforts, but give him credit, able to hold on to the football.
They'll run the option on third and short yardage. And that is incomplete.
Speed is the name of the game when it comes to RPOs, and sometimes you can be a little too quick, thus inaccurate, incomplete.
Tie game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down. Looking to throw from. And no, it's incomplete. The Bengals try it, but it doesn't work out. And the Browns are going to get this thing back. Excellent field position.
Turnover on downs.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. A completion, yes, but certainly not what they wanted, a loss of a full 6 yards. Looking to throw again on second down. Jackson, this ball complete to Rager. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down.
Third down.
The Browns on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 2. Jackson. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
The offense staying out. They're going to go on 4th and 2. From the gun, Jackson. And that is incomplete. The Browns unable to move the chains on 4th down. And the Bengals will get the football back.
The result of the play is a turnover on down.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. We'll see if they can grab the lead. Either way, what a job their defense did to force the turnover on downs to set up this opportunity. On 1st down, Fromm, quick slant, caught by Moore. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a 1st down.
1st and 10 at the 38-yard line.
They run the option here on 1st and 10. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Now let's see who this is on. First and 10, Fromm. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. That catch good for only a couple. So 2nd and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on 1st down.
It's 2nd and 8 at the 37-yard line.
Out of the shotgun, here's Fromm. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he was standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. Throwing is Fromm. And it's caught by Parker. That'll put him over 150 yards receiving now. Quite a ball game and a 1st down.
I know you don't get anything extra for degree of difficulty, but maybe you should. He's done absolutely everything in this game today, including laying out for that one.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's 1st and 10. Right around the 40. Just what you want on a 1st down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's 2nd and 2.
And a lot of times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
Before they're inside the 25. 16 yards, a 1st down.
1st and 10 at the 24-yard line.
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got it 1st and 10 as they search for a go-ahead score. They'll run on 1st down. It's Lindsay. And they'll get this down to the 10. Another nice. Nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
This defense needs a big play in the worst way because so far, they're not putting up much of a fight. If they don't get a stop here soon, this game could be over for them.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. Carry for Lindsey, and he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Now, what's the thinking here? Because a touchdown would be nice, but you've insured yourself a chance at 3 in the lead, so how worried are you about the 6?
You're not very worried about if you're confident in your kicker. And if you got a kicker who can put it through the post, you feel really good about trying to bleed that clock down. In an ideal scenario, your kicker puts it through the post as a clock.
And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. Philip Lindsay, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Bengals have broken our tie as they take the lead. He's got it as they go up by a total of 17-10.
Makes the score Bengals 17, Browns 10.
The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. No return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Browns take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started. They're down here in a one-score game, but the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time.
And that's going to be intercepted. Malcolm Jenkins, the Pro Bowler, and he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. McGreen, that's twice now in this fourth quarter.
As a quarterback, a lot of times you think it's all on you to make plays when you're losing. And here, the play's not there, but he throws it anyway.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd and 3 at the 26-yard line.
They'll go again with Lindsey. And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you've still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you've got to feel good about your chances.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
The Browns take over first and 10.
The Browns drive about to get started. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on 2nd down.
Brandon, that's just football 101. If you're out of the pocket, you've got to get rid of the football in this situation. You cannot take a sack in a 2-minute drill.
And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line.
Today's final score.
It's worth noting when you talk about Jackson's running ability, the Baltimore wide receivers had just over 1,400 receiving yards combined last year. And Charles, that was the fewest yards by a wide receiver group in the NFL since 2011.
And partner, I expect that number to go up this year. Last season, Lamar Jackson got very comfortable with his tight end group. In fact, he had one tight end and went to the Pro Bowl. But I think now, because